Hi, Lee Ellis here with your monthly installment of Leading with Honor Coaching. Speaking of honor, you probably have seen in the media, everywhere we turn, there are honor violations. It's like whatever happened to honor, you know? Well, I'm working on a book called Engage with Honor, Building a Culture of Courageous Accountability. See, I see these two going together. Honor and accountability are teammates. In fact, I see accountability as the guardian companion of honor. Now, we all want to be honorable. But the reality is, it's not just those people out there, it's right in here where the struggle is, and that we need to start here with ourselves, because human nature can drift off course. We may have a great idea about how honorable we are, but really we only a step or two or a few degrees off, and we're drifting way off from true north. I know that. I hope that you know that, because if you don't believe that, then you're really in danger. Because a lot of those people we read about in the news every day and see on TV, they thought they were very honorable. But now some of them are going to jail, others are on their way. So it's a human condition that we're struggling with in this whole idea of honor. So this month, I'm going to challenge you to choose honor. We're going to talk about it a little bit, and then we'll be talking about it for the next few months, because we'll be sharing from the book Engage with Honor, kind of an installment each month as we move ahead. Now, in the POW camp, I learned a lot about honor. In that crucible, I saw our leaders engage with honor and lead with honor in some very difficult circumstances. They overcame those obstacles because they had such a commitment, and they realized how important it was to our mission to be honorable, to live to our code of conduct, to respect our country, our families, our values, our uniform that we wore, and to be faithful to that. And they paid a price. Now, we all have to pay a price, and there are many impediments, actually, fears that we have. So many of us have fears about holding people accountable. We have pride about, first of all, starting with the leader. That's where it starts. You know, there are a couple of good books out in the last few years. One of them just recently, Supreme Ownership. It's put out by two Navy SEALs who are now leadership consultants. And they have a wonderful line in there that I've been trying to say in a nice way for a few years, but they put it very bluntly. It all comes back to the leader. If there's something wrong with the team, there's something wrong with the leader. So if you have problems on your team, you're the one that has to fix it. You're the one in charge of that. The other one is the Oz Factor. It says the same thing. They say when you have failures, you've done your best, but you look around and you're still having failures, you need to look in the mirror, because that's where the problem usually lies. That most people, 90% of the time, will be successful if they're led properly and held accountable. And that means that the leader's got to do his or her job in that process. So again, those impediments. Fear is a big one. People are afraid to do that. But when you approach it in a positive way, there's no reason for fear. Number two is pride. We don't need that. I can take a shortcut. That's another part of human behavior. We want to take a shortcut and find the easy way out. Actually, our brains are wired to find shortcuts. That's why we have elevators and escalators now. Don't have to walk up those stairs so much. But some of those shortcuts cut across areas of policy or guidance or law or ethics, and they get us in trouble. So we have to be careful about taking shortcuts. We have to always be correcting back to course. It's easy to drift. You know, they have airplanes now that have a voice that comes on when you're off course or you're doing something wrong and taking the wrong direction, and it will say, "You're getting off course, correct back." That's what we need in our heads, that voice that says, "I may be drifting off course here. How can I get back on course?" Accountability is that voice. It's like the stick and the carrot. You know, we have this great desire to be honorable, but we need the stick, that guardian companion, the accountability that we're committed to, that will help us to get back on course and stay on course. Just like when I was an instructor pilot teaching formation, we were always correcting back to be in perfect position. In navigation, we drift off course, we got to correct back. So we're being realistic about the fact that leaders, every human being, all of us are going to drift off course, but we got to correct back quickly. That's why we need that something that's telling us that we're off course and we're correcting. We need to correct back. So with those impediments in mind, I want you to choose accountability. And with those impediments in mind, I want you to be courageous. Courageous Accountability Model is the title of our model for being accountable and helping others be accountable. And we use the word courageous because usually it's the fears that take us out and cause us to start covering up things that we didn't do properly. So be courageous. Engage with honor. And over the next few months, we're going to tell you how. In the meantime, if you'd like to take our Leading with Honor assessment to find out how your natural wiring is, because that's going to be very important in this, go to leadingwithhonor.com and you'll be able to find the Leading with Honor assessment. It's a free assessment. It's a short one-page report. I think you'll enjoy it and give you some great insights. Look forward to seeing you next month.